Hello, and welcome to TI's Troubleshooting Tips series. When troubleshooting TI components, it's important to reference ti.com/troubleshooting. In this troubleshooting topic, we will cover the ABA swap. The ABA swap is a critical board-level troubleshooting technique which can help you save time troubleshooting and debugging your component. In addition, it will help determine the root cause more quickly and efficiently. Before we begin, let's discuss the ABA swap process in some detail. The ABA swap is a great verification technique that you can apply during the application troubleshooting process. It's important to know that the ABA swap helps to confirm if that non-conforming behavior follows that device under test, or known as the DUT. In this example, we will follow two units between two PCBs. As you can see, the devices are swapped between PCB A and PCB B. We then can verify the electrical results and then return the devices to the original PCBs to confirm if the non-conforming behavior follows that device under test. The optical inspection helps improve the detection of hidden anomalies which may go overlooked and help you save time troubleshooting. In this example, we show two figures of common issues which can be found from a simple optical inspection. These are bent leads, solder bridges, and very important is the detection of excess solder flux. Now that we've discussed the optical inspection, let's talk about the benefits of completing an ABA swap. The ABA swap can be applied to both complex and simplistic circuits. It is a valuable technique which will help us rule out the device under test as the root cause. It also helps to check for assembly anomalies, which can be solved from resoldering, reflows cold solder joints, and also cleans solder flux residue. Now that we've discussed the ABA swap benefits, let's go into more detail about the ABA swap process. The ABA swap methodology starts with two printed circuit boards and two devices, device A and device B. The first step is to remove the integrated circuit from the printed circuit board. TI recommends to utilize a solder rework station, such as a heat gun, to complete this process. In addition, a pair of tweezers and the weight of the PCB will help us remove the board from the PCB. Now that the IC is removed safely from the board, we can begin the ABA swap process. Now that the suspect IC was safely removed from the printed circuit board, we can mount device B to the original board to confirm the electrical behavior. Once mounted, mount the second device, device A, to the known good board and see if the issue is still observed. The last step is critical to the process and requires us to re-solder device A to the original PCB to confirm if the original setup is now functioning as expected or not. This helps us to confirm if the issue is related to a cold solder joint, flux contamination, or any other printed circuit board assembly anomaly. Now that we've covered the ABA swap process, it is important to mention that TI has additional collateral on ti.com to help with troubleshooting and debugging. As shown here in the slide, we see that TI has various quality policies and processes, as well as an E2E support forum and TI Precision Labs. Lastly, TI provides free software for download such as Tina TI for simulations. Thank you for watching this troubleshooting series on the ABA swap process. For additional troubleshooting information, please visit ti.com/troubleshooting.